So my first kind of response to this question of why we have smiting Jesus, like in the first couple of chapters, and then we have like super nice, I will heal you Jesus, in the other chapters, is we have this super helpful teaching by Elder Holland. He refers to when King Benjamin says, we will have to be as a child, submissive, meek, humble, patient, full of love, willing to submit to all things which the Lord seeth fit to inflict upon him, even as a child doth submit to his father. Elder Holland says, I think the only commentary needed for this verse might be regarding the line suggested God inflicts trials and burdens upon us. In English, the word inflict, which comes from the Latin infligere, has at least two meanings. One is to strike or dash against, and another is to beat down. But those definitions are not applicable to God or his angels. No, the proper definition of the word, as King Benjamin used it, is to allow something that must be born or suffered. Now, allowing something is a different matter. God can and will do that if it is ultimately for our good. I am going to say it again. God does not now, nor will he ever do to you a destructive, malicious, unfair thing ever. It is not in what Peter called the divine nature to even be able to do so. By definition and in fact, God is perfectly and thoroughly, always and forever good, and everything he does is for our good. So this is why it's so fantastic that we have living prophets who can say, who can interpret for us the scriptures.
Things that may cause a little discomfort.
Right.
Kind of changes a little bit.
It's a huge insight, yeah. I think. I heard the other day someone say that in the Christian tradition, generally, we turn to the scriptures to end the conversation. And in Jewish tradition, they tend to turn to the scriptures to open a conversation. Mm. Because we have modern day revelation, they are an open canon. And for us to really learn from them, we need to wrestle with them. We need to be uncomfortable sometimes. We need to think about things and wonder and ponder and worry about things. That helps us come to a better knowledge. This insight from Elder Holland has personally touched me a great deal, and I thank you for it. Mm.